Hi! In this video, we'll learn how to combine a lot of small details to create this beautiful fire animation. We'll be using a lot of effects in this project to achieve this look, but feel free to pick and choose from the myriad of effects offered by Alight Motion to make your own look. If you would like to follow along, you can download the project packages from the link in the description. Let's get started. Our starting project has just this background layer. Let's start by designing our matchstick. Let's add a rectangle to the project. Make it a little longer and a little thinner. Change the color and place it here. Now duplicate this layer and change the duplicate's color to a lighter color. And position this layer just to the right of the original and make it a little wider. This will give our matchstick a little definition. Now let's create the tip of the matchstick. Let's add a teardrop shape and change the color to black. We can then go to Move and Transform and rotate it 180 degrees. Let's leave this panel and tap Edit Shape and adjust the shape's properties until we reach a suitable size. Let's place the teardrop at the top of the matchstick. Now, long press on the teardrop layer and then select the matchstick layers and then group them together. Now, let's rename this group layer to Matchstick. To create our fire, let's add another teardrop shape to our project. Already, you can see this teardrop looks similar to fire, but we can make it look better. Let's tap Edit Shape and adjust the shape to match the project in the intro. Let's change the color of the layer and rename it to Fire. Long press on the grip to the right of this layer in the timeline. Bring it below the matchstick layer and align it. At this point, select the matchstick layer and go to Blending and Opacity, and select Multiply in the Darken category. This provides separation between the lit part and the unlit part of the matchstick. Let's animate the fire. To do this, we'll tap on the fire layer, tap Edit Shape, and animate the tail property to give some flickering motion to the fire. Add a keyframe at the beginning, and then go to the end of the layer and add another keyframe so you can make sure the animation will loop. Now place the playhead near the center of the layer and reduce the tail value. Tap Easing, and for each section, let's use the easing preset shown. We now have some flickering fire. Now let's add some waves to the fire. Tap on the fire layer, tap Effects, go to Distortion Warp, and select the Wave Warp effect with standard settings. The waves are at the wrong angle and quite strong, so let's change the angle of the waves to match the fire and reduce the magnitude of them. The spacing property controls how far apart the waves are. Let's adjust this slightly. We can animate the phase property to make the waves appear to move. Let's add a phase keyframe at the beginning of the layer and another at the end. If we change the value of phase to any whole number, the effect will loop cleanly. Let's take some time to play our animation. It's definitely improving, but let's make it more dynamic by animating spacing property. As usual, let's place keyframe at the beginning and the end of the layer, so we'll be sure our animation will loop. Now let's place the playhead at the center of the layer and reduce the spacing a little. This adds a nice little touch to our wave animation. Fire in the real world is more dynamic at the top and more stable at the bottom. But our fire is moving uniformly throughout. Let's change this by heading to the damping section of Wave Warp and change the values as shown. We can now see that the bottom part is not affected by the effect as much as the top anymore. We're definitely getting closer. Our fire has vertical movement, but it doesn't have any horizontal movement. To take care of this, let's add the swirl effect from the Distortion Warp category to the layer with standard settings. As we reduce the strength a little, you can see we get some sideways movement. Let's set strength keyframes at the beginning and end of the layer, and then place the playhead in between them. Let's make the strength a bit negative to make the fire move the other way. Let's add the easing preset shown to both sides of the animation. If we tap play, we can see the swirl effect has added some nice horizontal movement. Now let's add some texture to the fire. First, we'll add some glow by tapping on the layer and adding the glow effect from the drawing and edge category. You can change the color of the glow and also adjust the radius. Decrease the alpha and adjust the hardness to your liking. Now let's add another effect. This time, let's choose rays from the color and light category. This will make light rays appear from the fire. We're going to increase the length and raise the intensity. But feel free to change these to your liking as well. Finally, let's add the colorize effect from the color and light category. We'll use this to add a uniform tint to the fire layer. If we play this back, we now have a nice looking fire animation. Let's add some sparks to our fire. First, let's add a circle to the project. Let's go to Move and Transform to reduce the size, stretch it a bit, and then to Color and Fill to change the color. Let's also trim the layer to 1 second in length. This is one spark. However, we need a lot more. So let's add the Scatter Repeat effect from the Repeat category. Let's adjust the radius, making it so the sparks are spread throughout the preview. Let's also reduce the scale value, so that the spark copies will be different in size. Then let's animate evolution over the length of the layer to give some subtle movement to the sparks. Simply place a keyframe at the beginning of the layer, and then scroll to the end and increase the value of evolution to do so. Next, let's do the same with offset, increasing the value of Y at the end of the layer to give some upward animation. This is looking good, but sparks don't last forever. Let's make them fade out before the end of the project. Let's head to Blending and Opacity. Place the playhead near the end. Add a keyframe, and now move it all the way to the end of the layer and decrease the value to 0. We've used a lot of simple steps with a number of different effects to reach this moment, and it's paid off. How did your animation turn out? Please show us your creations by using the hashtag AMFireAnimation. If you have any questions, please make sure to ask in the comments. We'll do our best to help in any way we can.